See this, for example, let's think this is my browser, which is there on my laptop. You also have laptop. You install it or configure Tomcat on your laptop. And that Tomcat is running with 8080 port number. Yeah. Now I want to access your Tomcat. Yeah. http://. IP address of your machine, 172.34.5.6 something. This is your IP address. Yeah. If I type this, the request will come to till your laptop. In your laptop, I have a Tomcat running. You have Tomcat running with 8080 port number. So now if I type this, I will be able to see the screen of your Tomcat running on your machine. Why? Because I gave your IP address.
Yeah.
But if I give local host, if I give local host here, what will happen? Will the request come to your machine?
No.
It will. Myself is saying, check for an application which is running with 8080 port number in my local machine itself, wherever my browser is there. So it will check on my machine itself. It will not even go to internet. Understood?
Yeah.
I no need to have internet access also to access. But if I use http://IP address of your machine, do I need to connect to your internet? If I don't connect to internet, how can I will connect to your IP address? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Clear? Is it clear?
Yeah, I got it, sir.
Okay, is it clear? Let me know. If not, I'm not sure whether I got what is your question. I didn't get clearly. I tried
to got it, sir. I got it.
Okay. Anyone else has any questions, guys?
Sir, why yes we are not using HTTPS?
A brilliant question. Exactly. I appreciate you, man. See, HTTP means what? Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Okay, HTTP. HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol only, which is secured. Which is secured. Now, let me show you one thing. HTTP:// Amazon.com. HTTPS:// Amazon.com. As this is supporting with HTTPS, there is a lock symbol also, right? It means this application is secured. Okay, shall I take another 5 minutes, guys? Anyways, I started the recording. Shall I explain that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Five more minutes, not more than that. Okay. Now let me quickly explain this. Okay. See, I have two computers. This is my local machine. This is my Amazon.com or some other machine, right? Now there is an application deployed here. Now, if I want to access this application, right, I'll access like this, same like https://IP address, right, :8080 like this. HTTP, for example. HTTP, right? Now, for example, instead of IP address, I'm using a domain name, for example, Amazon.com. Now, it doesn't need a Tomcat 8080 port number. That mapping and all, I'll tell. For now, you think Amazon.com equal to IP address :+ port number. Okay. Is Amazon.com equal to IP address plus port number? You just think like that. Or else, let me write this only. 172.3.3.3. Like this. Okay. For example, this, just think this. This is the IP address of the Amazon application. Okay. Wherever you have Amazon application, right? Like this. Now, when you use HTTP, what will happen is, for example, I hit this, or else this is equal to this. You try to understand this. http://. You try to understand this, guys. Okay. So in general, when we type Amazon.com, the request will be like this internally. It will be converted like this. How this is and all, we will learn in AWS EC2. For now, you remember like this. This URL equal to this URL. Both are same. Just consider like this. Now, when I try to access Amazon.com like this, right, the homepage will come and you'll click on login page. It will ask you to log in. You'll enter your username and password, right? On your browser, when you open Amazon.com, right, and you click on login page and enter the username and password, right, it will ask for the username and password. Now, to check whether the username and password is correct or not, through this URL, the credentials, username and password, will be carried to your Amazon website, Amazon server, right? When Amazon application, it will have a database or something. It, for example, just think there is a database. It will check, this is username and password. Are there in my database or not? Yes, it's there. If it is there, it will log in. If the password or username is not there or else incorrect, it will throw login fail, something like that. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
But when you enter the username and password, right, and click on login button, the username and password carried will be carried from your laptop browser to somewhere where that Amazon application is running. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
In meantime, how it will carry is directly, however you entered your name, kctechnologiesdevops@gmail.com, something, password 123456789, something like that. You enter the username and password, right? The same will be carried as it is text format. So some hackers, if they come in the middle, they can easily take it. They can easily take it. Yes or no?
Yes.
So just think, there is a pipeline, pipe between your browser and Amazon application. If you enter the username and password, the username and password going through the pipe. If someone comes here, they can take your username and password and go. Yes or no? Yes or no, guys?
Yes, sir.
But I want to secure my username and password. I want to keep it secured. So what it will do is, you can use yes here, means there is something called as HTTPS, means secured. How to get this and all, there is a lot of concept you have to learn. But how it functions, let me tell you. When your application starts supporting HTTPS, when your application starts supporting HTTPS, then you can start using, for now, see this, localhost. Localhost 8080. If I start my application, it will work. But when I use HTTPS, let me start quickly. Let me quickly start my Tomcat also. Okay, Tomcat is running. Right? Sorry, shit, man. Localhost colon 8080. Okay. 8081. Okay, thank you. Thanks for many. 8081. I'm able to access this. The default HTTP protocol. But if I put it as HTTPS, you observe now. Now see this. When I type HTTP, right? Just only HTTP. Is there a lock symbol here? No lock symbol. Even if there is a lock symbol, it will be in a red color. Now HTTPS, I am using. Right, HTTP, yes. Now see, it is not working. It's not working. Means my application is not supporting HTTPS. Means it is not secured one. It is not a secured one. Now, if I use HTTPS, means my application has to support that HTTPS. My application has to support that HTTPS. Now, when my application starts supporting HTTPS, then only I can use HTTPS. Once if I use HTTPS, what will happen is, whenever you enter any details, not only username, password, any details, you are requesting for a shirt, you are ordering some shirt, you selected into cart, something, right? That when you when you add a shirt into cart, that will add on your name, that shirt will be added into your cart in the database. Or else you entered your username and password. And the username and password is carrying from here to here, on your browser itself, those username password will be encoded. Not like kctechnologies.com. At kctechnologiesdevops@gmail.com, password 123456789. Not like that. Those usernames will be converted into some special, like 1024 question mark equal to plus minus, something like that. It will be encoded. Now, even if someone reads this also, they cannot understand it. Now that will be carried it here. Automatically, when the request goes here, as your application is supporting HTTPS, this knows how to decode that also, how to decode that ABCD 1234 question mark plus minus. It knows how to decode that encoded code into kctechnologiesdevops@gmail.com. 1234567 89 password to decode into like that. So here itself, it will be encoded and transferred. After going here, it will be decoded automatically. Not encoded, encrypted actually. Sorry, encrypted, decrypted. Okay. Here it will be encrypted into some special code, right? Now after going here, it will be decrypted. Understood, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is the use of that HTTPS. Now when you use HTTPS, this is not the port number. 9443 comes into picture. Okay. So to do that, how we provide this security, how our application starts supporting HTTPS is through signer certificates. What is the signer certificates and all? There is a big history. We'll see later. Okay. Once when I get time, I'll explain about that also. Understood, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, everyone?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, while starting Tomcat, here we are able to see Java symbol. Sir, is it using Java in there?
Java. Okay, that is also one more good question. Let me tell that. The first itself, I would have said this, my mistake. bad memory, I didn't say, sorry for that. The prerequisite for Tomcat is Java. Same like Maven, the prerequisite for Maven is Java, right? Without Java, if you don't have Java on your mission, and if you try to configure Maven and run MVN command, it will say Java not found. They just were faced yesterday, right? If you don't have install Java or set the path correctly, then Maven will not work. Why? Because Maven source code is developed using Java. So if you don't have Java, Maven will not work. Same like that, Tomcat is also developed on top of Java. To create the Tomcat application, they used Java language, right? How we developed KC Technologies, KC Maven web project, one web project we developed, right? So some we use like that to develop Tomcat. Tomcat is one of the applications, same like KC, I mean, not comparing, like it is one of the application. So what language they use to develop Tomcat is Java. So to use Tomcat, you need to have Java installed and set the path. So if you don't have Java, Tomcat will not work. Understood, guys? The prerequisites for Tomcat is Java. Why? Because Tomcat is developed on top of Java. So you no need to learn Java, but you need to learn how to install Java and set the path. Clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. That's it, guys. Any other questions?
No. One question I have. WebLogic and JBoss is compatible to DevOps?
For each question, 500 rupees I'll charge next time. So it will be good, right? Okay.
So,
sorry, one more thing. Yeah, what is that question? JBoss?
Is the application servers like JBoss, it will is compatible to DevOps tools?
Yes, of course. You can use any application tool. Not only Tomcat, JBoss you can use, WebSphere you can use, WebSphere Liberty you can use, WebLogic you can use, okay? Glassfish you can use, any application server based on your requirement, based on your...
But WebLogic is a web server, sir, right?
No, that is also application server.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll tell you what is web server. If I give the difference now itself, right, you'll not understand. You'll not understand. First concentrate on this application server. When the time comes, I'll explain you what is web server. Okay. Just in the document, I gave one definition. What is web server, that and all. Just as there is application server, I have to tell that there is one more server called as web server. There is one more type of server called as web servers. One more category. Right. I just said one point. What are those? Why we actually use them? If I tell now itself, you'll not understand. When the situation comes, I'll explain you. Don't worry. Okay.
Okay.
But one more thing you asked, right? JBoss, can I use Glassfish, WebSphere? Yes, you can use. But in the automation process, when you use Jenkins to auto deploy, the process will change. I'll explain that in the Jenkins. You don't worry. You don't need to remind me also. I'll explain. That is the one topic. Okay. Don't worry. I'll explain. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any other questions? Google Pay 500, then ask. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, guys, that's it. Okay, we'll meet on Monday. Have a happy weekend. Full non-veg, veg, eat, enjoy. Enjoy match tomorrow, India-Pakistan World Cup match. Bye, guys. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Good night.
Good night.